We are going to discuss about Unit 4 of Module 2, that is Best Practices in Autism Spectrum Disorder. Let us first know what autism is. Autism Spectrum Disorder, ASD, is a complex neurological-based developmental disorder that affects a person's ability to communicate and interact, both with other people and with their environment. At one time, ASD was considered to be a rare condition. But it is now recognized as one of the most common developmental disorders affecting children. Prevalence rates have soared in the past decades. It is now believed to impact 1 in 110 children. Now we will discuss the different categories of autism spectrum disorder. As given in the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act 2004, ASD is an umbrella term encompassing 5 different diagnostic categories. They are autistic disorder, Asperger's disorder, pervasive developmental disorder, Rett's disorder, childhood disintegrative disorder. The figure in this slide shows the 5 different diagnostic categories under the umbrella term autism spectrum disorder. Lorna Wing, 1989, quoted that autistic children do have a fascination which lies partly in the feeling that somewhere there must be a key which will unlock hidden treasures. Lorna Wing in 1989. The very early symptoms of autism are: does not babble, point or make meaningful gestures by 1 year of age, does not speak one word by 16 months, does not combine two words by 2 years, does not respond to name, loses language or social skills. Having any of these 5 symptoms leads the parents and professionals to have further evaluations for the child by a multidisciplinary team that may include a neurologist, psychologist, developmental pediatrician, speech-language therapist, learning consultant, or other professionals knowledgeable about autism. Autism is a developmental disorder that includes 3 qualitative deficits: lack of socialization, lack of communication, lack of imagination. These 3 together are commonly known as autism triad of impairment or autistic triad. The figure in this slide shows the 3 autistic triad. Each of the above characteristics of autistic triad is explained. Impairment in socialization, social relationship. Children with autistic disorder might seem to be in their own world. Poor eye contact, for example, during interaction or for drawing attention to something. Does not use gestures, for example, they might not lift their arms to be picked up. Does not share enjoyment or interests, for example, they might not point to an object or even to share it. Do not show emotions or empathy. Do not respond to their names. Shows no interest in other children or peers. Do not engage in pretend play. For example, they won't feed a baby doll. Lack of communication. Children with autistic disorder might have little or no babble, have little or no spoken language, have echolalia, which means that they echo or mimic words or phrases without meaning or in an unusual tone of voice, have difficulty understanding and following simple instructions. For example, give me the block might be difficult for them to comprehend. Lack of imagination. Deficits in flexible thinking regarding interest, routine, perspectives and rules. Does not understand other people's point of view or feelings. Agitated by changes in routine. Cannot generalize information. Has special interest. This slide shows the range of IQ and continuum of skills like social interaction, communication, fine and gross motor skills, and sensitivity for individuals with autism. Assessment of skill behavior is an important step in teaching and training of children with autism. Some important diagnostic tools for autism are mentioned here. CARS, Childhood Autism Rating Scale, the checklist for autism in toddlers, autism diagnostic interview, autism diagnostic observation schedule, screening test for autism in 2 years olds, autism behavior checklist, behavioral summarized evaluation, Gilliam Autism Rating Scale. Other than these, there are two more standardized tests on Indian population which has been recently developed. They are Autism Diagnostic Checklist, developed by Banerjee 2007, Indian Scale for Assessment of Autism, ISHA, developed by NIMH. No single method for teaching students with autism is successful for all students. Each learner with autism has unique learning needs. Also, students' needs changes over time, making it necessary for teachers to try other approaches. The most strongly recommended approach for teaching students with autism are discussed here. TEACH, Treatment and Education of Autistic and Related Communication Handicapped Children, developed by University of North Carolina in the year 1970s by founder Eric Schokler. The TEACH approach includes a focus on the person with autism and the development of a program around this person's skill, interest and needs. TEACH developed the intervention approach called structured teaching, an array of teaching or treatment principles and strategies based on the learning characteristics of individuals with ASD, including strengths in visual information processing and difficulties with social communication, attention and executive function. Structured teaching includes external organizational supports to address challenges with attention and executive function, visual and or written information to supplement verbal communication, structured support for social communication. Structured teaching is not a curriculum, but instead it is a framework to support achievement of educational and therapeutic goals. This framework includes physical organization, individualized schedules, work system, visual structure of materials in tasks and activities. The goal of structured teaching is to promote meaningful engagement in activities, flexibility, independence, and self-efficacy. We can integrate structured teaching strategies into other evidence-based practices. TEACH provides diagnostic evaluations, individualized curriculums, social skill training, vocational training, and parent counseling and training. The structured classroom teaching approach is one frequently replicated component of TEACH. This structured teaching approach involves setting up the classroom so as the student know where to be, what to do, and how to do it, all as independently as possible. We can see examples of structured teaching in these pictures. PECS, Picture Exchange Communication System. This was the first program that used a picture-based system with children with autism as young as 2 years of age as a child's initial mode of communication. Children using PECS are taught to give a picture of a desired item to a communicative partner in exchange for the item. By doing so, the child initiates a communicative act for concrete outcome with social context. Phase 1 of PECS, to initiate communication. Phase 2 of PECS, to teach distance and persistence. Phase 3, to discriminate between pictures and symbols. Phase 4, to begin using sentence structures. Phase 5, to answer a direct question. And phase 6, to begin to develop commenting. The following picture shows examples of picture exchange communication system. The next strategy is flow time activities. Flow time promotes social interaction between an autistic individual and an adult. Adults are instructed to follow the child's lead and build on what the child does to encourage further interaction. By following your child's interest and motivation, help him or her to attend to you. Engage in a dialogue, take initiative, learn how to solve problems. For example, if a child wants to line up blocks, his or her parents will join the child with the intention of developing an effective interaction rather than demand that the child joins them in an activity of their desire. There are five basic steps to facilitate flow time. First, observation. Second, approach, open circle of communication. Third, follow the child's lead. Fourth, extend and expand play. Fifth, child chooses closed circle of communication. And the sixth, flow time activities. Rather than learning appropriate behavior by rote memorization, flow time allows the child to link intentions and behavior in purposeful way that are meaningful to them. Since adults join the child's activity, the child is motivated to engage and relate to you and the world meaningfully, spontaneously and warmly. Let's see examples of flow time activities. Social stories. A social story can be written or visual guide describing various social interactions, situations, behaviors, skills and concepts. Social story describes a situation, skill or concept in terms of relevant social cues, perspectives and common responses in a specifically defined style and format. The goal of a social story is to share accurate social information in a patient and reassuring manner that is easily understood by its audience. It breaks down a challenging social situation into understandable steps by omitting irrelevant information and by being highly descriptive to help an individual with autism understand the entire situation. Social stories are used to teach particular social skills such as identifying important cues in a given situation, taking another's point of view, understanding rules, routines, situations, upcoming events or abstract concepts, and understanding expectations. Social story models appropriate social interaction by describing a situation with relevant social cues and other perspectives and a suggested appropriate response. Let's see example of a social story. Applied behavior analysis and applied verbal behavior are reward system teaching techniques which using positive reinforcement for good behavior. The teacher works one-to-one with the student and provides short, concise instruction. A student receives a reward for a correct response. ABB is a form of ABA that focuses on language development and encouraging speech with rewards. Sensory integration therapy. Sensory integration therapy helps children with sensory or repetitive behavior issues improve sensory processing in problem areas. Therapists use game or activities that help the child better process stimuli, such as swimming or playing in specially designed sensory rooms. Relationship development intervention. Relationship development intervention is a relationship building therapy that improves social interaction and communication skills through one-to-one sessions between the child with autism and another person. The therapy usually begins with encouraging interaction between the parent and the child and then moves on to include other people to encourage relationships. Relationship development intervention focuses on non-verbal cues such as facial expression and body language and social interaction such as sharing and encouraging empathy. Visual learning aids. Many students with autism learn better with visual aids due to difficulties understanding verbal instruction. Visual supports should accompany lessons to help illustrate ideas. In fact, picture cards such as picture exchange communication system can help nonverbal children with autism learn how to communicate. Peer tutoring and inclusion. Many schools practice inclusion, which educates autistic students in the same classroom as non-autistic students. The idea is that students with autism learns faster and adopts appropriate social behavior by observing her peers. Peer tutoring is one-to-one teaching method often practiced in inclusive schools. In a structured environment, a non-autistic student leads an autistic student through a number of tasks with concise instructions. For a teacher approaching the education of people with autism, there are three basic rules to follow. Understand the nature and implications of autism. Structure and order the learning environment as far as possible so that it guides the pupil towards meeting expectations. Teach visually as far as possible. Teachers may follow these simple instructions to help children to overcome the problems. Remove distractors. Make a very clear workspace for the child if necessary, with the child's name and photograph on his or her table, chair, work tray, etc. Keep tasks short, structured and clear. Try to give one-to-one instruction after group instruction. Check the pupil has access to visual reminders and prompts. Example, cards with pictures of equipments needed or a written series of steps in tackling a task. Use a simple diagrammatic or picture sequence to show how a task should be structured. Be aware that children with autism often find it hard to realize that group instruction apply to them. Catch their attention by using their names before giving instruction. Keep the task simple and as short as possible. A small steps approach will work best. Ensure children are warned about impending changes of activities in advance. Ensure that simple timetable for each day in symbol or written format is clearly visible for the pupil's reference and point to the correct and subsequent activities to make the routine clearer. Finding the right teaching technique for child with autism may take some time, but it is not impossible. Let's sum up with a few helpful tips for parents and teachers to reach children with autism. Incorporate areas of interest into the lesson plan. Respect sensory issues when developing the learning environment. Use games, songs and arts to teach children when possible. Use positive reinforcement to encourage correct answer and good behavior. Praise your child and let her know that you are proud of her. Stick to the child's routine. Children with autism prefer strict routines. The right teaching technique for students with autism spectrum disorder will produce positive results. To conclude, with a ray of hope for all parents and teachers of children with autism, we can see the example of Vishal, a child with autism, who authors a book at the age of 6. Thank you all.